I want to talk about an anterior lumbar interbody fusion, or ALIF. Anterior means through the front, and lumbar is obviously the low back. Interbody means the disc, and fusion means we're doing a fusion. So ALIF, or ALIF. What is it? What are the risks? Why would we recommend it? So in some patients, fusion surgery is recommended. And an anterior fusion is one technique or way of accomplishing a lumbar fusion. I like to recommend anterior lumbar interbody fusion, in particular at the bottom disc, L5-S1. And the advantages of the approach is we can really open up the disc space with it. We can also give you a better curve in your low back than we are able to coming in through the back. And then the final thing is that we're not affecting any of the muscle in the low back because we're going in through the front. Now, the approach is done by an incision in the low abdomen by the general surgeon. And there's a pathway to get to the spine that is through a fascial layer or a fat layer underneath the abdominal wall. So to get there, there's very little muscle that's cut, and the approach morbidity or the pain associated with the approach is really relatively low in most cases. Once the general surgeon gets down to the spine, the biggest risk of surgery occurs, which is there are these iliac arteries and veins, large blood vessels, in front of the spine. And the most important thing with the surgery is to get those blood vessels behind the retractor and out of the way of this surgery. Once the hard part's done, I scrub in and remove the disc and put in the implant and some screws. We also put in cadaver bone. We don't really have enough of your own bone to do the fusion, so we have to put in cadaver bone. That portion of the surgery typically takes about 20 to 30 minutes. And it's relatively straightforward to do. Once the implant is in and the disc is completely out and we're happy, then the general surgeon proceeds with the closure. The patients typically after surgery will refrain from eating anything until the next morning. We want to give the bowels a little bit of time to wake up. And then the diet is gradually advanced as tolerated. Some patients will leave the hospital the afternoon after surgery, and then I would say the rest of them, maybe 50, 60%, would leave the second day, so two nights in the hospital. The patients will have some abdominal pain. They may actually have a little bit of back pain from opening that disc up, but the recovery and the pain is generally well tolerated. It takes about 4 to 6 weeks for you to feel like you're back on your feet and moving and engaging in your daily activities without significant symptoms. The main risk of the surgery, again, is injury to one of those major vessels. The other risk I would say is that the level that was intended to be fused doesn't actually go on to fusion. That risk is maybe 2 or 3%, which may require another surgery. The anterior lumbar interbody fusion surgery is a very successful operation that spares the muscle in the back, has a reasonably good recovery period, and is associated again with a modest risk of injury to one of those major blood vessels. We recommend it in patients, particularly at L5-S1, sometimes L4-5, but the bottom disc is the most common. And the main reason that we recommend it is to restore the disc height and the curve in the low back. And we've seen pretty good success with the anterior lumbar interbody fusion.